Now, while the Karnataka government is busy opening up Indira canteens all along Bengaluru, despite a lot of protests from civic authorities and from residents of the city, the fact is the city is still struggling with the biggest problem, and that is waste management. And yesterday we saw another example of that. We're getting you pictures from near the Bellandur lake, and all these cars that you see on your screens are covered with a thick cloud of foam. Yes, a thick cloud of foam. You would wonder where it's coming from, and it's coming from the lake. Now, this is a very regular sight in Bengaluru. It's not happening for the first time. Even last year, around the Bellandur Lake area, we saw these pictures of massive, massive clouds of foam coming out and covering cars, and it had become very difficult to move around. And it is being said that there were rains in Bengaluru just a few days back, and that may have actually triggered these clouds of foam around the Bellandur Lake area. So these are big questions for the authorities, and these pictures will really haunt the Siddaramaiah government. They will have to come up with answers closer to the election. Remember, this is a time when they are busy with popular schemes. But what about this? What about garbage? What about the condition of the city's lakes? And we're getting you earlier pictures as well. And take a look at this. Take a look at that. Massive, massive clouds of foam all over. Imagine the plight of citizens in that area. Pooja Prasanna will be live with us in... All right. Pooja, I believe, is live with us now. Pooja, the National Green Tribunal had ordered in April that all industries around the Bellandur Lake will be shut and imposed a 5 lakh fine on anyone found dumping waste in and around the lake. Why are we seeing these pictures over and over again? Is the state government not doing enough? All right, Pooja Prasanna will be back with us. But just to recap for you, the National Green Tribunal in April had ordered that all industries around Bellandur Lake be shut and imposed 5 lakh fine on anyone found dumping waste in and around the lake. But despite that, we're again and again seeing these pictures. Pooja Prasanna, I believe, is back with us. Pooja, why are we seeing these pictures? Has the state government, which is really carrying out a lot of popular schemes at this point, like the Indira canteen, not... keeping an eye on this, not giving this enough attention?
Clearly, they're not, because infrastructure of Bangalore... All right, Pooja
will be back with us in a couple of minutes.
...is falling up.
Right, Pooja, sorry for the interruption there. Please go ahead.
So over the last 3 to 4 days, the kind of infrastructure collapse that is taking place in the Bangalore has been extremely visible. We put out those visuals and images of parts of Bengaluru flooding because of rain overnight just a couple of days ago, and now these visuals of froth across 3 to 4 lakes in Bengaluru, not just an isolated one, but so much so that the froth is overflowing from the lake, coming onto the road, covering a bridge, engulfing that entire bridge that is built over Vartur Lake. Clear symptoms that all is not well. Infrastructure does need attention, and this has been brought up over and over again. Citizen activism has been extremely important in Bengaluru over the last few days, because they have brought up these issues and put it across to the government. But apart from giving empty promises and even allocating budgets to take care of these infrastructural problems on ground, nothing has changed. Every time we see something of this sort happen, Parikshit, all they do is send a tanker and ensure that the froth level goes down. But the core problem, which is sewage water coming into these lakes, and not just from the apartment complexes close by, but even the industrial waste that is let into the lake, was not stopped for a long time. And what is ironic is BBMP, which is a local municipal corporation, actually dumps garbage into these lakes, and this is visible every single morning. So that is the kind of civic apathy that Bengaluru is witnessing. And with a year away from elections, the Chief Minister and the Cabinet is more interested in cutting the red tapes of popular schemes like Indira Canteen. We saw the ASCC Vice President yesterday in Bengaluru talking about the achievements of his government, but the basic things like good road, clean water, clean air to breathe seems to be a luxury as far as citizens of Bengaluru are concerned.
Right, and imagine Rahul Gandhi did not mention anything about the garbage problem, the sewage problem, the traffic problem the city is facing, and he didn't even talk about how there has been violation of laws in many of the installations as far as these Indira canteens is concerned. Thanks very much, Pooja Prasanna, joining us live on this broadcast. We take